Everyone, today I'm going to be going over crate games to establish and maintain positive associations in the crate. I will start off by throwing high value treats into the back of the crate and have him go in the crate and then throw a kibble outside of the crate so he comes releases outside of the crate. And I'll do this a couple of times, at least 10 or 15 times in the crate and out of the crate. I always use high value into the crate so that you add value to the crate itself. If you hand feed, you're adding value to yourself, but if you reward on the crate itself, it will add value to the crate. In the beginning, you don't have to say much until they repeat the motion and understand what the exercise is. Or the game, rather. And then once they understand the game, then you can put it on cue by saying in the crate and out of the crate, or in the crate and free. Here I'm starting to close the door a bit and release go free. You'll notice that he'll start to do it on his own, which is great because it's a sign that he really understands the game and is having fun and values the crate. It's always good to capture an offered behavior and reward it versus commanding something all the time or cueing something all the time, because especially when it comes to crating, you want them to decide on their own that the crate is valuable and they want to go in. So think of the crate as a magic box. Every time they go in, they get, you know, treats, they get bully sticks, stuffed Kongs, games. So that's what's really important. Here I'm going to play some reverse psychology by placing lots of high value treats inside the crate and I've locked the door. He's trying to figure out how to get in. He really wants to get in, and this builds drive and desire to get into the crate. And when he's not looking, I'm actually going to unlock the crate door so that it builds his confidence in problem solving. Yay, good job, Lakota. You can do a combination of these games. It doesn't always have to be in the crate, out of the crate with food. You can also use toys or a snuffle mat inside the crate to do searching. Here I'm doing a fun game where I want him to do down and watch me, make direct eye contact. So I'm teaching him by luring him that I want him to do down and watch me, and then rewarding him. And then I'm going to release him. When he goes back in on his own, I'm going to see if he could figure out what I want. Yay, good job, Lakota. This is so important in a crate. I think the most important key to crate games, or a dog appreciating and liking to be in a crate, is that they're mentally stimulated inside the crate and that you establish this pattern of behavior that they use their mind for problem solving and for mental stimulation inside the crate. And if that pattern of behavior is established, then the goal would be achieved. Because if they can really, really use their minds inside of a crate, then that's what they're going to keep doing instead of predictably getting upset, anxious, because they have no other outlets. They'll start chewing the bars, barking, and those are patterns of behavior that you don't want. So I think really, really building this is great, and you want to keep playing these crate games throughout their lives so that they always maintain a positive association and that they go inside a crate and automatically their mind starts thinking about mental stimulation and problem solving. What I'm going to start to do is I'm going to start to build some duration and distance so that he learns that I don't have to be near the crate and the game would still be going on. So I'm gonna move away. And this is great because it adds value to the crate even when I'm not there. And it teaches him that the game's not over. He still has to think things through even when I'm not there. Good boy, Lakota. And this is wonderful for canine nose work, where the dogs are created when they're not searching. And so instead of them being anxious and whining and barking when you're away observing the other dog's searches, your dog will be perfectly fine because you have a sidebar game going on with them. Good job, Lakota. So proud of you. You always want to end these games with something positive or even a stuffed Kong inside their crate. Good boy. Give lots of praise and don't forget the rewards. Good luck, everyone. To test if you have actually maintained the right association, if they come into a room and they go straight into a crate, then you know you've done your job. Thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.